So in the last class, we discussed about resistance of a transmission line. Now we will get into the second parameter, which is the inductance of the transmission line system. So first case we are going to see is this inductance of a single phase two wire line. Okay, inductance of a single phase two wire line. Right. So how inductance will exist? When you have a current carrying conductor, then in the vicinity of that, what will happen? Then flux line will exist, and then that is how you have inductance, right? We define inductance as what? Inductance is given by flux linkage per current, right? Flux per current is what is meant by inductance. That is what we are going to find out. So for a transmission line, let me say when we have a transmission line like this, and first thing what we are going to see, a two wire line. Well, means inductance of a single phase two wire line. That is what we are going to see in the first part. So here we have a conductor like this, and we have what? We have another conductor, right? Let me say the first conductor's radius is R1 and second conductor's radius is R2. The distance between the senders is given by D. So in such a system, we are going to see what is the inductance of this total system and what is the inductance per conductor also we will see. Right, this problem means what? We have to find out the inductance. This problem, this really can be taken into two ways. One is what? When we have a current carrying conductor, then in skin effect you already have seen that inside this conductor also we can have the flux linkage, right? That there will be internal flux linkages. Like if this is the radius R1, then inside what? Inside also you will have what? Circular flux lines like this. Right, when your current is, let me say, flowing inside to the conductor like this, then if you take your right hand, then if you twist your fingers, that will give you what? The direction of the flux producing it. So you will have a flux in this direction. Right, so even inside the conductor also you will have the flux, and outside what? Definitely outside also you have what? Flux linkages. So in finding the inductance, the problem is taken in what? Two parts. The first part, it is caused by two things. The first part, what we will deal with, the internal flux linkages. What? The internal flux linkages, right? So the first part we will deal with internal flux linkages, and the second part we will deal with what? We will deal with the external flux linkage. External flux linkage. This is the way we are going to attempt this problem. Clear? Now you will see how first the internal flux linkages at first. Stop. So first we will see internal flux linkages. What is meant by internal flux linkages? So consider a conductor like this. This is the conductor cross section. And what? Which is having a radius. Let me say which is having a radius R. This is the conductor cross section having a radius R. So in that conductor, let us consider a cylindrical element like this. Okay, so let us consider a cylindrical element like this. Okay, this is a cylindrical element, like cylindrical ring kind of shape. So distance, let me mark it as this distance is what? X. And the distance between this small ring, that distance is dx. Okay, this is x and this is dx, right? So we have such a conductor cross section with us. Okay, now for the whole inductance part, one theorem we are going to use is something that you already know. So what is that theorem? That theorem is Ampere's circuital law, right? This is taught to you several times in different places, I believe. Ampere's circuital law, which states what? Which states that closed integral over the magnetic field intensity H, closed integral over H dot dl equal to the total current enclosed by that by that ampereal loop. Like you have learned it in electrodynamics means electromagnetics part in your high secondary and all. Gauss's law and is in electrostatics. Similarly, you have this Ampere's circuital law in magnetism. That the closed integral over what? Over the Hamiltonian loop. Okay, let me consider here that at point x, this is your what? This is your Hamiltonian loop. At point x, this is your Hamiltonian loop. The magnetic field intensity dot dl means what? Over this closed loop is equal to what? Is equal to the total current enclosed by that loop. Okay. Now our consideration is what? At this x distance, this is my Hamiltonian loop. So at that for that I am going to write my Ampere's circuital law. So at a particular from the center at a particular distance x on this circular on the circular periphery like this, on that part your around all the part your magnetic field intensity will be the same, right? Because it will depend on the distance only. When your distance is remaining constant over the whole circular periphery, then your magnetic field intensity also will be constant. So let me mark that magnetic field intensity as what? Hx. Okay. Now that's a constant, so we can take it out the integration. And closed integral over what? Over dl. Dl means that dl is what? Dl is this surface. Understood? This small surface, this inside, this small surface is what? That dl. So that cylindrical surface, if you take the integrate the length over the cylindrical surface, what it will be? That will be the circumference of this circle. What is the circumference of the circle? It is given by 2 pi x. Right? When your radius is x, then the circumference of the circle is given by 2 pi x. So hx into 2 pi x is equal to what? That is equal to the current enclosed. Right? The current enclosed. Now we should be very careful. What is the current enclosed? The total current overall to the conductor, the total current is what? The total current is I. Understood? Total current is I. So inside the current conductor cross section, your current is distributed. Let us say that current is what? Current is uniformly distributed. Current is what? Current is uniformly distributed. Current, if it is uniformly distributed, then what is the case? If it is uniformly distributed, then we can say it is all around the state place, it will be same. So, yeah, what will be the total, what will be the fraction of current which is enclosed by this small x radius? Understood? Inside this radius, what will be the total current enclosed? What it will be? Means, let us see. So, the total current enclosed will be what? Current enclosed will be equal to the current into, or it is around which area? Pi x square only, right? Over the area pi x square divided by pi r square, right? I by pi r square will give you current density. Into what? Into pi x square means what? The area of the small circle inside, right? So that will be give you the total current enclosed by this circle. Clear? So this will be what? This will be your current enclosed. Now let us see what? Now, if we write this equation, what it will become? Hx into 2 pi x equal to, what is the current enclosed? Current enclosed is I into pi x square divided by pi r square. Right? So, I can cancel out pi and pi here. So, it will become I into x square by r square. If I write Hx here, what will be Hx? Hx is given by, let us see, what will be Hx? Hx is given by I into x square divided by, here I already have what I have here. I already have 2 pi x, right? 2 pi x into here already that r square is there. This x and x square will get cancelled. So what will be left? I into x divided by 2 pi r square, right? This is the magnetic field intensity at the distance x. Clear? Now what is the relationship between magnetic field intensity and magnetic flux density? What is the relationship between magnetic field intensity and magnetic flux density? Right, this is a well-known equation, right? So, B equal given by mu into S, where mu is called as relative permeability of the medium, right? B equal to mu S, where mu is called as relative permeability of the medium. So, if I want to find out Bx, what it will be? Mu times Hx, right? It will be mu times Hx, which is equal to what? Which is equal to mu into x into I divided by 2 pi r square, right? This Hx I am substituting from here. Mu into x into I divided by 2 pi r square. That will be my Bx, right? Clear? Now let us see. Now the important part here is that when I say what I am saying here, I am saying that I have an Hx and I have what? I have the magnetic field intensity. Now let me say the current is flowing into the current is flowing what into this board, okay, or into the conductor like this. Then what will be the direction of magnetic flux? Then you have to take your right hand. Then whatever be the direction in which the current is flowing, if you take the direction of curl of your fingers will give you the direction of flux. So right, so the flux will be what? It will be along this circular rings, and flux will be got moving through this direction. So this is the direction of flux phi. That is the direction of flux phi. Now, if this is the direction of flux phi, and I already got what? Bx, right? So in this small area, this small distance is what? Dx. In the small tubular loop, if you see, like it is what? It is flowing in along this circular loop. So if I draw it like this, so along this tubular area, right? So if I take this small area like this, what? DL and this area, small area, understood? So this part is what? The circumference of this thing, and this is what? Dx. So here you will have a means into the conductor you will have what? You will have a rectangular area like this, where this is what? This is dx, and this is the length of the conductor, right? So flux is what? Flux will be either going inside into this area or coming out of the area. That will be that will be how your flux will be. So if the length, if we equate as what? One unit, okay. If the flux is taken as unity or 1 meter, then what? Then how can we find out flux? What is the relationship between flux and magnetic flux density? Flux means if this is a small area, right? So let me mark it as what? D phi. If it's a small area, then it is what? It is just d phi, right? Small distance dx. So this is a what? Small area. So d a small area, and that whatever flux is there, let me, if I mark it as d phi, then what it will be? That will be given by what? Bx is the magnetic flux density. Magnetic flux density into area, right? What is area? That area is bx into dx into 1, right? 1, why I took? Because when it comes to transversal line, its length will be changing, right? So, in what we will do is that inductance or resistance or anything else, we will always tell per meter, per unit length. That is why we are taking the length as what? 1 meter. If we know per unit length, we can tell it for what? 100 kilometers. Like the inductance is like 1 Henry for 1 meter. Inductance per meter is 1 Henry. We can say what? We can say that for 100 kilometer, it will be, we can extrapolate that, right? So the same way d phi is given by what? Bx into dx into 1. What? D phi into bx into dx into 1. 1 here means what? It is for unity. Okay. So this bx into dx into 1, let us see what we, how can we write that. That bx into dx into 1 means what? Bx is what? Bx is mu x into I, right? Mu x into I divided by 2 pi r square into what? Into dx, right? So this is my, not bx, this is my what? This is my d phi. This is my d phi. Correct. This is my d phi. If I integrate it all over the surface, what will happen? If I integrate it all over the surface from 0 to 1, I will get the total flux. Right, total flux. But I already have told you what is inductance. Inductance is given by what? The flux linkage per current. Right, lambda by I. So if we take this distance, if we take this distance, what will be the total flux linkage? If d phi is there, let me say the flux linkage is what? D lambda. Flux linkage will be what? It will again depend on how much area it is covering, right? Or means just the fraction of current, whatever we say. Similarly, how much area we are covering. So d lambda will become what? Pi x square divided by pi r square into mu x I divided by 2 pi r square into dx, right? So here we can cut off what? We can take out, no, we cannot take out anything. We can take out only the pi, right? So what it will become? Mu into x cube I divided by 2 pi r raised to 4 dx. This is your small d lambda for this particular small area. So in order to get a total flux linkages, total flux linkage means what? If we take it from 0 to r, that will give us what? Total flux linkages. So what we have to do? Lambda equal to what? Integral over 0 to r, right? Then we will get the total cross section of the conductor. What? The d lambda. D lambda is what? Mu into x cube I divided by 2 pi r raised to 4, right? 2 pi r raised to 4 dx. right? This is the total flux linkage. Now let us integrate. How can we integrate this? So if we see here mu, then what, 2 pi r raised to 4 and I, current I, they are all constant. So all what we are integrating with respect to dx only. So let us take them out. What we will get? We will get mu into I divided by 2 pi r raised to 4 integral what? Integral over 0 to r. What it is? X cube dx. Right. It is x cube dx. So what we will do? Mu into I divided by 2 pi r raised to 4 into x. What is the integration of x cube? It is x raised to 4 divided by 4. So here it is what? X raised to 4 divided by 4 with the limits what? 0 to r. Right. So again what we will get? We will get delta raised to 4. This is what? 0. If we put it is 0 only. So if we put r what? R raised to 4 divided by 4. Right, then this r raised to 4 and this r raised to 4 will cut. We get cut and this will get multiplied. So total what we will get it as mu into I divided by 4 into 2, 8 pi. Mu into I divided by 8 pi is the total flux linkage. Total flux linkage is given by what? Mu into I divided by 8 pi. Clear? Now what is our interest? Our interest is to find out the inductance due to this internal flux linkages. As I already said, L is given by what? The flux linkage divided by current. We already have found out the internal flux linkage lambda. What it is? Mu into I divided by 8 pi. Right. Mu into I divided by 8 pi is the total flux linkages divided by the current. So this current and this current will go. What will be left? It will be given by mu divided by 8 pi. This is my total inductance. This is the total internal inductance. Okay. So what is the value of mu? If mu is given by mu is mu zero, right? Or relative permeability, if we consider it as one. Then what is mu? Mu is given by mu zero mu r. Mu r is taken as 1. Then mu is given by what? 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 Henry per meter. Right. 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 Henry per meter is what? The mu value. So if we substitute that here, what we will get? L is given by 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 divided by 8 pi. Right. Divided by 8 pi. Usually it is given by what? Henry. But since we are talking about what? Since we are talking in terms of unit length, this will be given by in what? Henry per meter only. Because in our calculation, we considered what? Per unit length. Right. So it will be per meter here. So if we cut out this pi and pi here, what will be left to us? 4 and 2, if we cut out, it will be 1 by 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 Henry per meter. 1 by 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 Henry per meter. This is the inductance due to internal flux linkages. This is the total inductance due to internal flux linkages in a conductor. Now let us see the effect due to external flux linkages. Okay. What is meant by external flux linkages? Like you have a conductor like this and we have considered what linkages inside now. So whatever be outside. So there means outside this conductor also what? You have a current passing through the conductor and you have flux lines outside the conductor in air also, right? So that is what is meant by external flux linkages. So in external flux linkages, let us consider an area like this, okay? An area like this, right? So flux linkage will be what? Circular rings, right? Circular flux lines will be in circular rings around the conductor. So in that part, let us consider this two circular rings like this. Distance that what? Let us say the first one from the center, this one is distance that d1 and the second ring is distance that d2. Okay, so this is our consideration. Understood. So what we are going to see here is that the flux linkages between two points. Okay, let me say this is p1 and this is p2. Two points. Understood. For a solid conductor. Understood. Okay, and where this is external to the conductor, right? So this is D1 and this is D2. Let us consider what again? Let us consider a tubular element like this. Just as we considered inside the conductor, here also let us consider a tubular element like this. And this distance is what? This distance is dx, right? This distance is the dx part. Now tell me in which direction. Let me say the current is flowing. The current is flowing in this direction. Then in which direction your flux will be? In which direction current is flowing in this direction? Then the flux will be what? Flux will be in this direction, right? So consider this is our situation, right? Now when we have to find out flux linkages of flux, what we did in the internal flux linkage case, we considered Ampere's circuital law. So what is Ampere's circuital law? Integral x dot dl equal to the total current enclosed. Right. So this is our Ampere's circuital law. Here also let us consider that at a particular distance x, this is what? Till the tubular element, whatever be the distance, let us consider it as what? X. At that particular distance x, let our magnetic field intensity be what? Hx. At the particular distance x, our magnetic field intensity is given by Hx. And what is if we integrate it over the integral over dl, what it will become? If x is the distance for the circular tubular ring, then what will be the total perimeter? It is given by 2 pi into x, right? The circumference of that ring. It is distance that x distance, so total it is 2 pi x, which is equal to what? The total current enclosed. Let me say the current passing through this conductor is I. Now you tell me what will be the current enclosed by this ring? The same total current. In internal flux linkage we had a fraction of current, but here what is the case? Here the total current is enclosed by this Ampere circuital law. Right, whether it is for any external flux linkage case, it is the same, right? For any flux external to that, if we consider our Amperean loop, always what? The current will be completely enclosed. So here we can write what? The total current I. Hx into 2 pi x equal to the total current I. Then what is Hx? Hx is given by I divided by 2 pi x, right? No confusion here. Here we don't have to think about fraction of current because the whole current is enclosed by our circular ring. So Hx is given by I divided by 2 pi x. Now what is Bx? Bx is Ec, right? For Bx we have to multiply Hx into permeability. So mu into I divided by 2 pi x. This is what Bx. B is given in what unit? B is given in Weber per meter square. Right, B is given in Weber per meter square. Also, we call it as what? Tesla. Weber per meter square or Tesla. This is Bx. Now we will get into the procedure is same here and there. Okay. Now we will get into what? Now we will get into that small flux in this small area. Right. This small area, this small tubular ring, whatever flux is going. Right. Per meter. Again per meter. What is flux? Small area d phi means what? Flux means what? The Bx into area. Right, magnetic field intensity into area. Magnetic field intensity is given by mu I divided by 2 pi x. Right, into area. What is the area again? Here our distance is dx. Inside that we are considering only for 1 meter. In order to express everything in per meter. So we can write it as dx into 1. Okay, 1 need not be written. So mu I by 2 pi x into dx. Now interestingly here, if we take the flux linkage d lambda, means small flux linkage. If we take the flux linkage d lambda, again what? Just similar to our current enclosed, here also what? The total current is enclosed inside. So whatever be the small flux d phi here, the same will be what? Linked with the whole thing. So d lambda will be what? Same as d phi. So mu I divided by 2 pi x into dx. The internal flux linkage again, it will be what? It will depend on the fraction, right? Fraction of that area. So here we don't have to consider that. Here we will get what? Mu I by 2 pi x into dx. Now, in order to get the total flux linkage, right? Total flux linkage from what? P1 to P2. Or whenever our distance is varying from what? D1 to D2, we have to find out the total flux linkage. Let me mark it as what? Lambda 1 to D1 to D2. So it is given by what? Integral over D1 to D2 d lambda. Right? Mu I divided by 2 pi x into dx. Right. So this x, if we vary with dx from d1 to d2, then we will get the total flux linkage all over the place. So this is lambda 12. What it is, here again the constants are what? Mu I divided by 2 pi integral over d1 to d2 1 by x dx. What is integral of 1 by x dx? What is integral of 1 by x dx? The integral of 1 by x dx is what? Ln, right? So mu I divided by 2 pi into ln, right? Ln x from where to where? From d1 to d2. So that we will get as what? Mu I by 2 pi into ln d2 minus ln d1, right? Ln d2, if we apply the limits, ln d2 minus d1, right? When it is logarithmic, the difference between logarithm, how can we write? We can multiply, we can get it as the sum of that inside operation. So mu I divided by 2 pi into ln d2 divided by d1, right? This is the lambda 12. So the top flux linkage is given by mu I by 2 pi into ln d2 divided by d1. Clear? Now our interest is what? So now if we consider the inductance due to external flux linkages from point 1 to 2. The inductance due to external flux linkages from between what? Between points 1 and 2. If we consider, what we will get? The inductance between points 1 and 2. Okay, that only if we consider. Again, it is given by what? Lambda 12 divided by the current. What is lambda 12? We already know. So this current and this current will get cancelled. What we will be left with? Mu by 2 pi into ln d2 divided by t1. Right? Mu by 2 pi into ln d2 divided by d1. Now let us see. Again, same thing. What is the value of mu? If we consider mu r equal to 1, if we consider mu r equal to 1, then our L12 is given by what? Mu means what? 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. Mu 0 only, since our mu r is 1. Divided by 2 pi into ln d2 divided by d1. So this pi and pi will get cancelled. 4 by 2 means what? 2. So it is 2 into 10 power minus 7. Ln d2 by d1. Right, what is the unit of inductance? Inductance unit is what? Henry only. But since we are considered only for 1 meter, it will be given in Henry per meter. So this is the L12, means what? Inductance due to external flux linkages from point 1 to 2. Okay, this I considered in order to get the case for which we have done this one. What we have a two wire conduction system, and in that how to find out the total inductance. Okay, let us see that. Our interest is to find out the inductance of a single phase two wire line. Okay, now we have seen for a single conductor what is the inductance due to the internal flux linkages, and we have also seen for a single conductor between two points, what is the inductance due to the external flux linkages between two points. Okay, now let us see what happens in the vicinity of another conductor. Okay, here also we will consider one by one. So let us take the first conductor, and how the flux linkages will be produced. Flux linkages will be produced in this manner, right? So this is, let me say, this is the flux linkages produced. Okay. So, as you know, from this Ampere's circuit and law and all, it will depend on what? The current enclosed also. The current is flowing in this direction, right? Into the circuit. And here what? The first conductor, if current is flowing like this, then second one is what? It is the returning conductor. So, that current direction will be in the opposite direction. That is why this I marked as crossed, and here I have put a dot mark. Right? So, here current is flowing into the system. And here what? Current is flowing from the board, right, towards you. So if this is the condition, right, if it is a single phase AC system, then what? The two wire will have what? 180 degree out, it will be 180 degree out of phase. Understood? If one is like going like this, another one is coming. So anyhow, so this is our condition. And let me tell you one thing. Like if we take start d means what? Distance from the center of the conductor to the distance to the center of the other conductor. Right, if I take d plus r2, if I take more than d plus r2 means what? More than this periphery, if I take, what is the total current enclosed? Here let me say the current is plus I, and here what will be the current?
it will be minus I, because here it is coming back. This is a returning conductor. So outside D plus R2, what will be the total current? It will be 0. So total flux linkage also will be what? It will be 0 outside the conductor, or whenever your distance is D is greater than D plus R2. Okay. Whenever it is greater than D plus R2, then this is the case. I forgot to tell, R1 is the radius of the conductor 1, R2 is the radius of the conductor 2. D is the distance between them. So D plus, if it is more than D plus R2, then what? Then definitely you don't have any flux linkage outside D plus R2. And when you come up to what? When you come to the level of what? D minus R2, means at this level, right? This is R, this is till this is D. From here to here, it is what? D minus R2. When you come lesser than, whenever your distance is lesser than D minus R2, means inside this, inside here, then what will happen? Then definitely the total current, the total flux linkage current will be enclosed, will be what? It will be the complete fraction. Or even the flux also, what? The flux linkage will be what? Complete fraction will be enclosed, not 10. Okay, that it will be what? Like linkage will be what? The complete fraction. Understood? So that is the case. And if we consider that these conductors are a little bit far away, if these conductors are far away, then this D minus R2 and D plus R2 we don't have to consider. Instead, we can just write it as what? D, because R1 and R2 will become negligible. And even if they are considered, and even if the distances are smaller, till this assumption is valid. Okay, this assumption is valid. So another condition. Here, we are, how can we write the total external, let us first see the external flux linkage part. How can we write the external flux linkage part? We have already seen that L12 is given by what? It is given by 2 into 10 power minus 7 ln D2 divided by D1. Right. Here, our distance is D. We will take for what? First, we will take for this conductor. What? For which conductor? For the first conductor alone. For the first conductor alone, if we take, then what will be the case? In that case, you are starting from what? From where you are starting? From the center of the first conductor. Right? From the center of the first conductor to what? To the distance D. As I said, D plus R2, D minus R2, we are not considering. Right. So, in the same equation, what we will get? L external. Let me write L external. L external will become what? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln. In place of D2, what we have? The total distance D. So, ln D divided by what is from where we are starting? External flux linkage means what? It is starting from the periphery of the conductor. So, for ln D by D by R1. Right. Well, distance D, right, from ln D divided by R1. Understood. So, this is the external flux linkage equation. But 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln D by R1. Now, if we consider for the conductor 1, if we consider the total inductance, then it is a sum of sum due to internal flux linkages as well as external flux linkages. What we got for internal flux linkages? Internal flux linkage, it was a constant given by what? 1 by 2 into 10 raised to minus 7. Right. Plus external is what? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln D divided by R1. Clear? This is the total inductance due to the first conductor alone. This is the total inductance due to the first conductor alone. Okay. Now we should do some modifications here. Okay. Now we should do some modification. What are those modifications? Let us see. Okay. We will do some modification. What are those modifications? Okay, L1 is given like this here. So let me take 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 as common. Okay, L1 is equal to, let me take 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 as common. So already 1 by 2 was here. What it will become? If I again take out 2, it will become 1 by 4. Plus what? Plus this is the same. What? Ln into ln D divided by R1. Right? No problem with that. I took out the 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 part. Right? This is given in what? This is given in Henry per meter. Right? Because we are only considering for unit length. So, Henry per meter. So, this is the thing. Now, 1 by 4 is there and ln D by R1 is there. If we want to combine this, it might have been easier if this also is what? This also is in the form of logarithm of something. So what we will do, if we have to get it as the logarithm of something, we can write it as what? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 into ln of e raised to 1 by 4. What is ln of e raised to 1 by 4? It is 1 by 4. So I can write like this, ln e raised to 1 by 4 plus ln d divided by r1. No problems, right? Now the interesting part is that now we can multiply it and write. So what it will become? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln of d by r1 into e raised to 1 by 4. I don't want to keep it in the numerator. I will keep it in the denominator. Then what it will become? This will become e raised to minus 1 by 4. Understood? So this will be what? Ln d divided by e raised to minus 1 by 4 into r1. Ln d divided by e raised to minus 1 by 4 into r1. Okay. Clear. This is the thing here. And this e raised to minus 1 by 4 into r1, that we normally represent as r1 dash, which is equal to what? 0.7788 r. Okay. E raised to minus 1 by 4's value is what? 0.7788. Okay. So that r. Okay. Now the interesting part here is that why we are doing this? This equation, what this equation is meaning, the meaning of this equation is like, our total inductance for L1 is given by now 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln d divided by e raised to minus 4 into r1, which is given by what? R1 dash Henry per meter. Okay. Here, what we are doing is that there is a change in the inductance of the transmission line due to internal flux linkages. That is what this e raised to minus 1 by 4, and now we make it as what? Or this 0.7788 watt. This 0.7788 stands for the effect of the internal flux linkages. Okay, the effect of the internal flux linkages, we are covering up how we are compensating it, not covering, we are compensating it by what? By adjusting it in the radius. Are you understanding? So now if for the r1 dash radius, instead of r1, if I have r1, I am considering that what the first conductor is having r1 dash radius, in that case I don't have to consider the internal flux linkages. That got compensated. Understood? It is getting compensated with the application of this multiplication factor 0.7788. that is the need for that is what is meant by that. Okay, now when you have two conductors and you will not see internal flux linkages directly, instead what, you can directly write the equation for inductance while keeping the rate, while changing the radius. The real radius you will change into what? 0.7788 times r. Okay, if we have say 5 cm radius, we will multiply it with what? 0.7788 to get the r1 dash value, so that we don't have to consider internal flux linkages as such. Now it just got inside this equation. So this is the total inductance of the first conductor. Total inductance is the first conductor. Now similarly, if you have a second conductor, what it will be? It will be again what? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln d divided by r2 dash. Right? For the second conductor there, it will be given by ln d by r2 dash. Right? That is the thing. So for now, I want you to now we want to write it for what? The two-wire system means together. How can we find out the total inductance for a two-wire system? As I said, current is flowing in this direction here, and current is coming out from the conductor. So here, what is the direction of flux? I have to put my finger into the conductor, and current is, flux lines are coming like this. And what about this one here? Due to this conductor, again, what will happen? Current is flowing towards you, right? So curl of direction of curl will become what? It will become like this, right? So here it will be like this. Here it will be like this. But what? Flux between here, what will happen? Flux is what? Getting aided. So in this condition, we can write the total inductance as what? L1 plus L2. So what it will become? If it is total inductance L1 plus L2, what it will become? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 into, right, I will take it as common, into ln d divided by r1 dash plus ln d divided by r2 dash. Right, I think you don't have any confusion now. Right, ln d divided by r1 plus ln d divided by r2 dash. That is the total inductance here. Right. Now, since again it is what, the terms ln are getting added, so that we can again add together. What it will become? The total L equal to L1 plus L2 is what? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln into d square divided by r1 dash r2 dash. Right. So this square term, if I take out the square term outside ln, what it will become? It will become multiplication, right? m raised to m square, if it is then, if I take it out, what will become? It will become multiplication outside. So this will become what? 4 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln d divided by, I have to take out square from here also. So this will become what? Root of r1 dash r2 dash. Understood? Now mostly, you know, mostly what will happen, your r1 dash will be equal to r2 dash, which will be what? A constant r. Right, always it will be always what? R dash, okay, r dash. Whenever your radius of the two conductor will be same. Under that condition, what will be inductance? Inductance is given by 4 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln d divided by r1 and r1 dash and r2 dash became same. So it we can take it out of square, out of the, we can take that out of the square. So it will become what? R dash. Okay. R1 dash equal to R dash means what? This will be R dash, this will be R dash. R dash square it will become. So square root will go and this will become R dash. So this is the total inductance. This is the total inductance of what? Two-way system. And it is usually called as what? Inductance per loop. Inductance per loop. This is called as inductance per loop. Because why? Because this is equal to L1 plus L2. We have considered the two conductors together. That is why it is called as inductance per loop. L is given by 4 into 10 raised to minus 7 d by r dash Henry per meter. Clear? Now the another part is the, when we are considering only for one conductor line, that is what inductance per meter length for inductance per conductor. This is called as inductance per conductor and given by what? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln d divided by r dash. Okay, d divided by r dash Henry per meter. This is what inductance per conductor. Inductance per conductor. There is a difference that you should understand. When to the total system, we call it as what? Inductance per loop, because it includes what? The current flowing part and the returning part, both of them are included. That is why we use the term loop. So that is inductance per loop. When we are considering for only one conductor, it is called inductance per conductor. The two things you should understand the difference. Okay. So with this, we are concluding our inductance of a single phase two wire line system. Now we will get more into detail about other transmission line systems in the next class. And one major thing that what you should understand is that your R dash is now what? 0.7788 R, which accounts for what? You have a radius here, but in order to adjust the internal flux linkages, you are multiplying it with the 0.7788 R e raised to minus 1/4. Okay, thank you.